season, launched what we call the Beyond the Tent. And that was why I said that the Memphis in May International, with the collaboration we are having with Ghana in 2020, is a very opportune, you know, event for us, because then we have just launched the Beyond the Tent, and this will be one of the signature events that we'll use to highlight the 10-year project on the Beyond the Tent. And so I commend the organizers of the Memphis International, and I thank and commend the Minister of Foreign Affairs for really collaborating with my ministry to get this event to come on successfully.
The organizers of Memphis May International Festival have recognized the creative abilities of some of our young music talents and have selected Sapodia and Stone Boy to perform at the Bill Street Music Festival. Work is also in progress to select the highland musician to perform as well. The Ghana Dance Ensemble, put together by the National Theatre of Ghana, will perform at a special cultural show and in schools across Memphis. A Ghanaian chef will also present some Ghanaian delicacies to the people of Memphis at a show named Cuisine of Ghana. Two more chefs from Ghana Barbecue Association will also compete in the World Championship Cooking Contest. Furthermore, a long-distance runner from Ghana will compete in the Great American River Run. In the field of arts, pieces from the National Museum and Arts Alliance Gallery will be on display in prominent museums in Memphis. A performance on Ghana's slavery resistance, put together by Institute of African Studies, will also be aired in the National Civil Rights Museum in Memphis. Selected Ghanaian films to be screened at the cinema of Ghana in the Memphis series are Burial of Hoju, that is 2019, Sinking Sands, 2010, Beast of No Nation, 2015, Potato Potato, 2017, and Concrete to Me, The Road to Accra, 1983. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in the bid to help Memphis youth appreciate Ghanaian culture, all public, private, and homeschool teachers in Memphis began using the curriculum of Ghana in January 2020. Equally, 10 students from some second cycle institutions in Ghana will take part in the festival's award-winning International Student Exchange Program in Memphis. Ghana will also host a similar number of students from Memphis. Furthermore, Ghanaian technocrats in the field of trade and economy, economic policy, information technology, life sciences, logistics, and architecture will be given platforms to address various Memphis groups during the economic development segment of the festival. This will allow for the establishment of business and professional relationships between the people of Ghana and Memphis. As we are already aware, great majority of chocolate consumers know little, if any, about the cocoa value chain. This festival will present the opportunity for the Ghana Cocoa Board to hold a display of Ghana's cocoa value chain, the Cocoa Village. This will help the city of Memphis and its visitors to have a finished experience of the first-hand experience of the long journey of the chocolate bars they enjoy. In all, about 40 Ghanaian selected participants will have the opportunity to be sponsored by the festival organizers.
I am pleased to be here on behalf of Shelby County. Shelby County is a large community in Tennessee in the South, and Shelby County is comprised of 7 cities. And our most important city in Shelby County is Memphis in May. And so this is one of the really special occasions for all of our community, particularly the city of Memphis, because Ghana has served as such an inspiration, its history of freedom fighting and justice, and even what we see happening in Ghana right now with the year of the return. So I'm pleased to be here with this delegation, including Commissioner Mikhail Lowry, whom I serve with, but also my daughter. I did not want her to miss an opportunity to be exposed to all that is good that is going on in Ghana. So she's taking notes right now so that she can be prepared to report to her community, her classroom, all that is going on in Ghana. So on behalf of the city of Memphis and the mayor of the city of Memphis, Jim Strickland, I bring greetings. We're looking forward to the Memphis in May celebrations, which will happen in just a few weeks. We think that'll be a great opportunity to experience the music, the cuisine and arts and fashion, to bring all of that to the city of Memphis and also share some of our cultural uniqueness. We are an African-American community, a majority African-American community, and so this will be a very special collaborative effort. With an extensive list of programmings honoring Ghana this May, there's no question that this will be one of the biggest cultural salutes that Memphis in May, our festival, has ever produced.
Okay, guys, so we are at the official press launch for Memphis in May 2020 International Festival that will be happening in Memphis, Tennessee in the U.S. And we're privileged to have the board chairman,
board chair with
us here. So he's going to give us a brief insight on what people who are going to visit Memphis in May should expect, especially those visiting for the first time. So thank you so much. How has your stay in Ghana been so far?
So far, so good. I'm returning. I was here in October, and I'm back now, and so far it's been very good. No more than was expected. The warm, friendly hospitality of Ghanaians has been wonderful.
How has preparation towards this year's Memphis in May, you selecting Ghana to be an honorary country, what went into that selection process, and how has the preparation towards the event been so far?
The selection process, we had several countries that were excited about being a part of the Memphis in May, wanted to be honored, but Ghana topped them all. Ghana was very receptive, was very cordial, easy to work with, and made the hospitality of us honoring Ghana easy. It wasn't a hard decision for us to be able to honor Ghana, especially after visiting Ghana. We went back and immediately started publicizing that Ghana was our honored country, and it's been an overwhelming reception.
How's preparation been, working with the Ghanaian team and your team back in Memphis? How has the preparation been, and how ready are you to receive Ghanaians who are visiting Memphis in May?
Like I said, the ambassador from Ghana was on top of it from start to finish. His office was very receptive and very cordial. I mean, they worked untiringly to make sure that everything was connected and well organized. We came to Ghana in October and visited with all of the ministries here, and all of the ministries were receptive. Our educational platform was put together, and the Memphis education community has been receptive of it and has done a wonderful job of educating our kids about the culture and traditions of Ghana.
So those who have concerns and fear about, the pandemic, corona, how prepared is your organization to welcome people, without they having to worry or be concerned about the coronavirus, visiting?
Well, we're utilizing the Center for Disease Control they've had some events already, some festivals larger than ours that have already decided to cancel. We have decided to continue because in hopes that a cure or some vaccine will be created or the virus will dissipate on its own over the next, we have 7 weeks, so we're going to work up to the why before we make that decision to cancel the festival in May. So we may be as close as the second or third week in April before we make any final decisions on it. But right now, we're going forward full steam ahead, excited about it.
That's amazing.
Yes.
Thank you so much, and wish you the best of success.
Thank you so much. Keep us in your prayers.
We will.
All right.